Hello everyone, welcome back to this another new tutorial. And in this one I'm going to show you how you can extract the 2D information from a 3D data. So basically the idea is I have a match move camera and I want a 2D tracking data from any specific point in a 3D space. So this is the comp script I have, and this is, by the way, the one of my upcoming course. So this is the forest scene which we created in Blender, and this is the final comp you are seeing on my screen. And so in this one I just want to focus on how we added this. I just quickly play this final one. If I play this shot, so this is the entire shot of the course, and in that course I will cover everything, how I assemble the shot, how I comp this, how I add the god rays, and you know, pure creative and the lens flare and everything. But now let's focus on the god rays, and you can see it's pretty good coming. And I want to show you how I track this god rays and how I place it here. So let's see how we can extract the 3D information into a 2D information. So this is the whole script, and here in the backdrop I just want to show you, in the top I have this asset backdrop. So let me just zoom in on the point. So here, as you can see, I have this backdrop, and here I'm using the reconciled 3D to get a 2D information from a 3D camera, right? So we have this match move camera here. You can see it's moving, right? Yes, let me just quickly show you. So it's moving in a scene, and I placed one axis here. So let me take one new reconciled 3D node, and I place the camera here and axis here. When we view from this, you will see nothing. So you can place a constant here, or you can place your input image, because there is three input like this. For now, I'm just placing a constant. When you view from here and go to a 3D space, let me take new axis just to show you. So we can move this one like this in a 3D space, and we just need to find the exact 3D position where we want that 2D tracking data. So in this case I want the sun position, so I just place this one. I'm just assuming my sun is right in this direction. Okay, when we do that, let's go to the 2D space. Here we don't need to change anything. All you need to do is just press this create keyframe and select the global, so we can get the frame range, and just press the button, and you can see the magic. It's calculating all the camera motion and storing in this 2D point, and where we adding that axis, it is automatically calculating this one. And now you can see we have this 2D information. Now what we can do, we can use a transform node, right? And you can just, you know, simply just copy pasting this. You can just link this one like this, control click, and you can just link this one. And now you can see the axis is going here. So what you do, we just need to zero out the center, and you can see is move it here, right? And this is what we get. So that is exactly what I did. I just delete this one. This is just to show you. And if I press shift E, you can see this expression link. If you go down in the script, it is linked to this god rays node. If I view this god rays node, you can see this is the animation, and it's linked like this. And I think I use this somewhere else. Yeah, here in this god rays also. This is the another god rays node, and you can see they both are animating based on that, and it's linked, right? So that's how you can use this one. And I just want to show you one more thing. For example, I'm just taking god rays node here. Let's see. So let's take the god rays node, and just what we need to do, we just need to connect this center point to this center. Now it's move on this exact position. For any chance, if you want to offset this one, but for now I just want to move it here. I mean it's not possible because it's linked. So in that case, what you can do, you can take a no op node, and in this one you can just quickly add, we can go to the user knob menu, and you can add a floating point slider, and just you can say like offset in here also, offset. And minimum and maximum, I will give you the minimum 0 and maximum 10. And if I press OK, done. Now here I have slider. So what I can do, I can go to my center, edit expression, and in this one I can add like plus, and I can type the no op. We just need to type that one, and then dot and the offset, right? And you can see that value will come. So just copy pasting this one, adding here, and press OK. And now we are good to go. So now this both are linked here. So what is the advantage? So if I open this panel, so now I can move this one. So it's better to, like, we just need to edit this one, and this is like offset X, and this is offset X. So we need to create a two slider. So I can add another floating point slider and offset Y. Offset Y. Again, minimum 0 and maximum 10. So now I have a two slider. So let's go back again in this one. Now let's offset, we can say like offset X, and here we can say offset Y, right? Now if you click, now they are linked, and now I can offset in X and Y. See this? We can offset the whole animation. So what I can do, I can go to user knob, again edit, and you can say like minus 10 to plus 10. So this one also. So that way I can have a slider in the center. Now I can go back here. So this way you can offset and you still have that animation. Okay, now with this we can just offset this one like this and it will still follow that. See this link to this reconciled 3D, but we are controlling, we are offsetting the position with this no op node. So that is the advantage, you can do stuff like this. But you can see it's coming inside the frame. So I can say like I want more, this dot need to come inside more in the frame, so I can do like this. And that is the whole idea, guys. So that way now I offset this one, but it is still following the motion, right? Because it's link, it's expression link, right? So that is the idea, and that is exactly I want to show you, so we can do that. So this is like very small tip, just want to show you how you can use that reconciled 3D, and that's how I use in that. So there are a lot of things I need to cover in this one. So this course is still in progress. I will try my best to release this one as soon as possible. So stay tuned for that, and thank you so much for watching, and I hope you learned something and want to quickly play this one last time. So this is the output, guys. I hope you like this one. So there is one more output from this render, and by the way, so this is the raw render, and the one more output which I changed the so in that one I changed this scene completely. So I will show you that in the course. Till now you can see this is the output. So thank you so much for watching, and we will see you in our next one. Have a great day.